on me. Red dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, then that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind. Listen, yes, Lord. Lord, yes, Lord. Lord, yes, Lord.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not. For Lexin', I fell out and cut the check. My not, my not. Palaz, the set, but I been taking hits like I can't die like innocent. Morning the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it. The nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well. Yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack in my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad.
They say summer is the time to live in Chicago. Well, that's extended into autumn as we are ready to roll under blue skies at Soldier Field. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and ready for football are we as the Bears get set to match up with the Detroit Lions. A pair of 3-0 teams set to lock horns for the right to remain unbeaten. And we're off in week 4. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First carry now for David Montgomery, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Give him 3 there on the first play of the game, and it's second down. To throw is Fields. And the hookup here to Allen Robinson. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first. First down. First down at the 45-yard line. Fields on first down. Forced out to his left. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Fields now to throw. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. 39 yards there, a big one. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Montgomery. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Once more, Montgomery. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. David Montgomery. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Bears take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Santos able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Off play action. Here's Goff. We'll find Bryant. His tight end. It's complete. And a loose football. And this is picked up by the Bears. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
So the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. He'll buy some time right. Going for it all. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Marquise Goodwin, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Bears are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Santos with the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. Rolling to his right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
First down, Murray. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Big Eddie Goldman there on the tackle. Now gone. Throwing deep for Murray. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. Latavius Murray, the intended receiver, out of the backfield. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. They run from the shotgun with Murray. Murray, strong running. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. First down, Detroit. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Goff, flush to his right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Nice work to get 7. Of that, and it's 2nd down. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Second down and 3. A shotgun handoff. This is Murray now. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal. Goff now to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And this is thrown to the sideline. No receiver in the area, though, and that's going to bring out a flag. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
So after the loss of down, they'll come up here with a 2nd and goal. Again, it's Murray. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They get five on the run, but it leaves them with a tough third and goal forthcoming. Gone. Hit as he throws, and the ball is out. It's a live football.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Seibert's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
But what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Hand off comes to Montgomery. And he's got some space here. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Another first down there as this one goes for 25.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 34. Now a run with Montgomery. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, the so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
Fields on third down. They'll roll him out right. The improvisation gets him only a couple, but that's all he needed. First down.
But nowhere to throw it, deciding to scramble, and a nice job, CD, got the yardage that he needed.
Yeah, and his teammates are certainly going to appreciate that effort, even if his coaches don't, because they would have wanted him to slide and protect himself. But he chose team gain over personal protection.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery. Romeo Okwara in on the tackle. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Eluding the pressure right. Close to the sideline, he finds Robinson complete. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Fields to the veteran Robinson for the Chicago first. scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Here's Fields. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Justin Fields with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year, as the Bears push further out in front. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, here's Santos to kick this one away. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room down 21-10 as opposed to 21-3. 21-10, a little more optimism, a little more bounce around the locker room, a little more discussion about how they're going to finish this thing off. 21-3, I think discouragement clouds that locker room.
Yeah, and I think a touchdown much bigger than a field goal on this drive just to get into the end zone and get that momentum. Second and 10. Goff. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Keon Crossing. And they will score a pick six for Bears touchdown.
Part of what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. Santos with the extra point, and the rout is on here in this first half. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they gave up the pick six. And now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be.
Just rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Dane Cruikshank. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one cause fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. Now Fields. Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. Trey Flowers, the former Arkansas Razorback, in there to get him.
I think this defense, Charles, realizing the deficit they're facing, they're going to have to step up and make more plays like we just saw there.
Yeah, and those are the type of plays that can focus a defense because, as we know, they've had their troubles so far in this one. But they just proved to themselves that they can get to him, and I expect them to continue to bring that type of pressure in order to try and turn around their fortunes.
It'll buy some time right. Caught by Montgomery. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. First down for the Bears, a gain of 15.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down,
They might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now. Light a fire under these guys. They got.
And he's got Mooney in the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Well, CD, when you combine accuracy with a big arm, you get throws like that. And Justin Fields may very well be making these kinds of plays at the pro level for years to come.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield. And you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
Yeah, the next-gen stats showing that at an even 57 yards through the air. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with the score where it is, even though I think they'd love to get back to the locker room, they may be forced to try and get something out of this drive. He's going to let it go again. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Second and 10. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. Goff and his guys not coming off the field. They're going for this. They go ahead and snap it. Goff. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. What a real head scratcher there. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. They'll run on first down. Montgomery. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Now a give running left with Montgomery. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. David Montgomery. As the first half is winding down, and the Bears would extend their lead here just before halftime. Santos with the extra point, and a rout is on here in this first half. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Not wanting to risk anything here late in the half. He'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Offense ready to kick off their next drive as they take over with just 17 seconds left before the break. Now a first down throw. Goff. Into the secondary, past the 40. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Now Goff on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And this is caught, and he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Khalif Raymond in the final seconds of the first half. And the Lions are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And they get a bit of a respite here from what's been an otherwise dreadful first half of football. So time enough for a kickoff here. 5 seconds remaining in this first half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And with 5 seconds to go, this will likely be our final play.
They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. Offense ready to kick off their next drive, and they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done, and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely, but you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
Play action, it's gone. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
From the 31, Goff flushed out right.
He'll drop this one off to Swift.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and it'll be third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time.
And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Third and two, Goff. And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And they will score a pick six for the Bears touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He didn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Santos now to add the PAT. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead will swell by one more. Get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
Well, you think he might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Boy, he ran free there after the catch as that winds up going for 38. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll try the right side with Murray. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
They'll fake the give. Now gone. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 19. Goff on target to Hockenson for a Lion first down. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. The offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10.
We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three. Mike three. Mike three. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
Now it's Goff off the bootleg. Rolling to his right. This is caught. And he'll be out of bounds. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Let's go, D. He's crashing. He's checking.
Maverick.
Now they'll run, Murray. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
36.
Another run for Murray on second down. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one. They'll run for it. This is Murray. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. On fourth down, Goff. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Kadarrell Hodge, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Lions' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone, and he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And it would seem as if their three-game winning streak is about to go to four, but still a little work to do as they start first and 10. They find some open field here. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 101 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Second and five now. Fields escaping the pressure right. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. From the gun, it's a give to Montgomery. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. They'll run it. Here's Montgomery. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. And they pick up the first down there with a gain of 4.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Still 9 remaining on second down. Out of the gun, Fields steps away to his left. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Remember, they have won 3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. The throw complete here to Williams. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Looking to throw again on second down. Goff flush to his right. He'll get this into the hands of Hodge. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Goff now looking to throw. Dancing to his left. He'll get this off to Swift. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. To throw again on second down, Goff. Open man is Raymond. He's got it. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 30. 12 yards there as they move the chains. On first and 10, Goff. Throw caught by Raymond. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. It's a pickup of 6. Throwing again is Goff. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured.
And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good, and that will cut this lead down to 25. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Chicago, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0, and they will hit the road next week. Meanwhile, for the Lions, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings.
Section where you're not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted. Playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting with do for a purse. Disgusting with do for the clout. I'm one of the realest. The realest could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt. You gotta pay my. Salute when you see me.